Hello viewers, this video is created in order to guide you in an efficient way while explaining some terms to those unfamiliar with the game Dead Cells, an indie Souls-like game released on Steam on 6th August 2018, winning 4 awards and being nominated for 6 more. It also received high praise from many reviewers and had an overwhelmingly positive review from players. Each level in Dead Cells has its own atmosphere, secrets, and blueprints for new items. It's 25 levels, 7 bosses, and 200 plus weapons, skills, and costumes ensure replayability, along with 6 unique runes and 5 boss cells. It is enthralling to play. So, let's get started. This is the Dead Cells template on the official website. In the first run, we'll be going through Prisoner's Quarters, Promenade of the Condemned, which will be giving us the Wine Rune, Ramparts, which will be giving us the Customization Rune, and then we'll be greeted by Concierge on the Black Bridge. First kill will give the Challenger's Rune. The journey till here will be relatively easy compared to what's coming next. Stilt Village will not only be one of the most smelliest places on Dead Cells, but will also be swarming with monsters that will be difficult to interrupt. Pirate Captain is one such being. Clock Tower also gives you 3 new hard enemies, Bombardian, Dark Tracker, and Cannibal. Clock Room really gives me a fuzzy feeling. Being killed on every try in 2 cells just brings a smile on my face. Upgrade your equipment as much as possible and you'll be fine on 0 boss cells at least. High Peak Castle hosts 3 elite monster fights you will be required to fulfill to unlock the King's Door and the Treasury. Hand of the King will be your final boss fight and a complete disaster if you don't know what's coming for you. After pulling all the Uno Reverse cards in your deck and barely defeating him, it will present you with its 1 boss cell, so that the cycle gets harder and continues for eternity. The tips for all normal stages. Dodge Roll is the best ability in the game to help you survive. You can dodge all attacks and even perform this in mid-air. Stomp deals a devastating amount of damage to minions, sometimes outright killing them, and can also be used mid-air. These two can actually be combined and are frequently used in Ramparts. That will help you not get stunned if you don't choose to use the elevator. Instinct is the yellow exclamation mark above the enemy's head. It indicates the opponent's attack. So, dodge, block, or parry. Get close to the enemy and hack him to pieces. Cursed Chess. Drop a scroll, a fully upgraded weapon, and a few more goodies. But you will be cursed. A small hit will result in your death unless and until you kill 10 enemies. So do it carefully and the curse will be lifted. Scrolls, which you may have heard twice now, are the best things in the game and a must-have. Go through every single level and search thoroughly for the scrolls, for they will ensure your survival and decrease the difficulty of the game, because you will get stronger. Your weapons will have more damage, your health will be higher. Also, you can use all your skills and weapons mid-air alongside stomp and dodge. This will be very helpful with your boss fights as they will frequently cover the ground with a lot of AoEs. Ice grenades or frost used on enemies roaming in a pool of water will be frozen. That is, they won't be able to move, attack, or lock onto you in any way. A similar process will be taken place if you use the electric whip. It will electrocute them and damage them over time. But don't be overwhelmed. A group of 3 or 4 minions is fine, but once you start feeling congested, do perform a tactical retreat. Familiarize yourself with the minions. It may take a long chase, which may end up in your demise. But remember to familiarize yourself with not just the stage, but all minion attack patterns. Do this and all cells will seem easy to you. Upgrade the equipment as much as possible to kill the boss ASAP and use proper equipment for each of them. Concierge, for example, can be killed easily if you have a frost grenade and a bear trap with you as skills. For Timekeeper, it's better to have a frost grenade and a fire grenade or root grenade or bear trap with a long range weapon and a shield if you have a habit of parrying. Hand of the King will be easier with dagger or high level whip, plus frost and frost grenades and the fire ones as skills. Be ready to give up. This advice may seem contradictory, but if you are stuck on a boss or a stage and just can't get through it, take a break. You'll figure it out eventually. This is the walkthrough on PC with WASD as movements, J as use, K as primary weapon, L as secondary, Q and E as skills, spacebar as jump and shift as dodge.
Thank you.
thank you for watching. I'll be continuing making guides on how to prepare for one cell in the least amount of time and then how to clear it. And so on till 5 boss cells. Remember to like, share and subscribe to this video and this channel. Comment down below if you have any doubts or suggestions. Just anything, to be honest. And have a nice day.